Hari ini 20 hari bulan, 20 September 2021, 8:38. Oke, berapa ramai? Sudah 43 orang. Like I said, I'll wait until 11:05. In the meantime, if your gadget is able to, you can have a look at the GC. I've added a few things in the Google Classroom. I added the Google Form, number one. And second, I added the instructions for your assignment. So, arahan untuk assignment sudah ada dalam GC. Nanti kita akan tengok sama-sama. Okay, we've got 44 people waiting for one more minute. Okay, 46. Okay, already 11:05. Okay, I think I can get started now. Okay, so once again, good morning, everybody, and welcome back. We are going to go into chapter 6. In today's video. Okay, everybody ready? Do some learning? Everybody ready?
Ready, miss.
Syukur, ready. All right, let me just share my window. Okay, I'm sharing this. I hope you're able to see it. All right, like I said, I'm going to get started by teaching you about chapter 6. So sebelum ni kita belajar pasal genetics, inheritance in families and then in a population, now we are going to look at the DNA itself. Okay, dari kita tengok populasi, sekarang kita masuk kepada setiap sel dan apa yang terjadi dalam nukleus dan DNA untuk setiap sel. So this chapter is called Expression of Biological Information, and we will have four subtopics. The four subtopics is DNA and genetic information, DNA replication, protein synthesis, and gene regulation and expression. So we are going to go into 6.1 and 6.2. I don't know if you want to go into 6.3 this week. We will have a look at that later. All right, so this first part I'm going to go into 6.1. 6.1 ini dia sangat ringkas dan dia juga berfungsi sebagai pengenalan kepada keseluruhan chapter ini. Okay, for 6.1, this is your learning outcome. You should be able to state the concept of central dogma. Dogma is a principle or set of principles laid down by an authority as incontrovertibly true. Dia boleh dikatakan sebagai tunjang ataupun asas kepada sesuatu kepercayaan atau sesuatu bidang. Okay, dia adalah prinsip asas lah. So biasanya perkataan dogma ini digunakan dalam konteks agama, tapi digunakan juga dalam konteks biologi sebab bila kita cakap pasal central dogma of biology, dia berkenaan dengan DNA dan apa yang kita sangat yakin DNA kita. You can follow me? Boleh?
Boleh, Miss.
Are you all able to understand? Okay. If you have any questions, feel free to ask, yeah? Saya risau pula tadi suara saya tidak sampai. Okay, so that is just the learning outcome, nibar pengenalan. Okay, so DNA and genetic information, we know your genetic information is stored in our DNA. Semua kita punya C, G, T dan A itu membawa maklumat yang akan menjadikan kita sebagai kita lah. Semua gen, semua protein, semua ciri-ciri kita dalam DNA. Okay, when we talk about DNA, we look at how it is able to replicate and pass to younger generation. Ini macam ayat bunga-bunga sejak in slide ni. Don't worry so much. Okay, so this part is starting about the central dogma of biology. Menurut prinsip asas atau prinsip utama dalam biology ini, central dogma of biology ini, apa yang dia nyatakan pasal DNA? When we talk about DNA, our genetic material, our DNA must be able to do these two things. Our DNA must be able to store our genetic information and pass it accurately from our generation to the next generation. And second, our DNA must be able to express the genes through protein synthesis, which includes transcription and translation. So yang pertama ni adalah DNA boleh buat salinan diri sendiri supaya kita boleh pass dia daripada generasi kita kepada generasi akan datang. Kedua, maklumat dalam DNA boleh dikeluarkan melalui proses protein synthesis yang merangkumi transcription dan translation. These two points and the whole process is the central dogma of biology. Prinsip asas ataupun tunjang kepada bidang biology adalah kita tahu DNA boleh menggandakan diri dia. DNA can replicate itself. That is what this first part of the diagram is. DNA can undergo transcription to produce RNA. RNA can undergo translation to produce proteins. Kalau kamu mau ingat apa itu concept of central dogma of biology, kamu lukis dulu benda ini, baru kamu cuba bina ayat dia. Progression from DNA to RNA, RNA to protein is the central dogma of molecular biology, dan jangan lupa dua ciri-ciri genetic material tadi, yang poin satu dengan poin dua. Okay. And there is also a video on central dogma of life. Okay. Ini sepatutnya ada bunyi, tapi nanti kamu boleh tengok sendirilah ni video. I'll attach the link in the GC as well. So it's a very simple concept and it serves as an introduction for this chapter. Okay, so dalam konteks central dogma ni kita belajar pasal DNA replication. It is the process of producing two identical replicates from one original DNA molecule. How it replicates itself is by semi-conservative replication mechanism based on Meselson and Stahl experiment. Okay, ini ada kenapa namanya semi-conservative replication mechanism? Sebab ada beberapa teori lain. Dan teori yang paling tepat adalah yang ini. Okay, so far any questions? Any questions about the central dogma of biology and DNA replication? Kalau okay, kata okay. Kalau tidak, kita teruskan.
Okay, Miss.
Alright, thank you. Okay, let us continue with the next part. Okay, so tadi itu adalah DNA replication. Seterusnya adalah DNA to RNA. For our DNA to create RNA, biasanya mRNA, it is a process of transcription. Transcription, menulis script. Okay, it is a process in which genetic information in DNA is transcribed, copied to form mRNA. Ini adalah ayat cantik ya. Kamu tengok diagram pun rasanya kamu sudah boleh paham DNA hasilkan mRNA. Itu adalah transcription. And after transcription, you will have translation, which is the process of producing from RNA to protein. Daripada RNA tadi, you will have translation, which is a process of interpreting or translating the genetic information or codon in the mRNA into sequence of amino acids, also called polypeptide. Secara ringkasnya, translation adalah dari mRNA kita hasilkan protein. Ini adalah ayat definisi dia yang panjang dan cantik. Any question about transcription or translation? Okay.
Okay, Miss.
Alright. Okay. So that is all for 6.1. Begitu saja ringkas untuk 6.1. 6.1 is just concept of central dogma of biology. You can draw this. You can look at this diagram. It illustrates what is the concept of central dogma of biology. Lepas ni tinggal kamu buat nota dan teruskan dengan 6.2. 6.2, 6.3, 6.4, dia punya maklumat lebih panjang. Okay, so just now that was an introduction to what is DNA replication, what is transcription and translation. Dan last kali yang kamu belajar 6.4 adalah lac operon, which is how we turn on or turn off a gene. Saya rasa macam sesuai untuk buat 6.2 minggu ini. Do you want to do until 6.3 this week? Or until 6.2 saja? Kak tidak kisah, asalkan saya upload nanti kamu tengok.
Boleh juga, Miss.
Boleh juga, okay. Then I will upload the videos until 6.3. Kalau sempat saya record sampai 6.4, saya record 6.4 dan upload terus juga. Okay. Okay. So for the rest of this, it is yang selebihnya adalah apalah? 6.3, 6.2. So nanti itu saya akan bagi dalam video. Panjang lagi lah dia punya nota. There is about 90 slides for this chapter. Tidak banyaklah sebab kebanyakan slide itu adalah yang saya kasih cantik-cantik dan saya kasih spread macam ni. Okay, so that is pretty much what I want to say. The rest I will show, the rest I will teach through YouTube. Can I give notes early?
Boleh, Miss.
Sekejap, saya tinggal mau edit lagi yang 6.4. Saya mau kasih cantik sikit and then I will send it to you in the group, kan?
Okay, Miss.
Alright. Saya bagi hari ini jugalah. And then this chapter is not that difficult if you have the video. Chapter ni senang saja kalau kamu ada video dia, cuma mau ambil masa sedikit untuk digest dan hafal lah. It will be in your UPS2, but it will not be in your PSPM. Chapter 6 tiada dalam PSPM, ada dalam UPS, jadi objektif saja. Kenapa dia tiada dalam PSPM? Sebab dia digunakan untuk kamu punya assignment. So, when you go into your GC, you will find this assignment PB punya folder or topic and you will see the instructions and the assignment draft submission slot. Nanti kamu boleh hantar di sini. So, if you go into the link, you should be able to see this. You should be able to see the instructions. So far, boleh nampak screen saya?
Boleh, Miss.
Boleh, Miss.
Okay. So let's have a look at this assignment. It is a case study, which means you read this, you answer it as if you are scientist studying a case. Seolah-olah macam kamu sedang mengkaji sesuatu case, kamulah scientist, kamulah menjawab dan tulis kertas paper. Alright. So there will be 15 marks for this assignment. You must do this assignment individually. It is divided into 3 sections. So the first section called case study 1, everybody must do. case study 2 and case study 3, you can choose either one. Satu wajib, dua dan tiga, boleh pilih mana satu kamu mau. Kerja kamu boleh type, you can type your work or you can handwrite it. But whatever method you choose, it should be submitted as PDF file. Jangan send sebagai Word, sila save sebagai PDF. And please also include your details such as name, matrix number, tutorial class, and lecturer's name. Nanti kamu perlu buat front cover. The front cover, we have it in Word format. Okay, dalam folder yang saya bagi itu, kamu boleh jumpa itu front cover. Nanti kamu boleh download buat salinan sendiri. Tulislah nama, matrix number, tutorial class, lecturer's name. Kalau kamu mau version PDF untuk print terus, pun ada di sini. So, okay. Saya baca habis dulu arahannya. And then plagiarism, which is meniru, and late submission will be penalized. So, kalau kamu meniru kerja kawan kamu atau kamu lambat hantar, kamu akan didenda. Tengok keberatan dia, tengok kami decide lah. Draft must be submitted by next week, which is 1st of October. And the final submission must be submitted by 22nd of October. Draft dia bukanlah kamu bagi ayat yang rangka karangan yang ayat tidak lengkap ya. Draft maksud dia ayat lengkap sudah, tinggal kamu bagi saya cek, lepas saya tanda, saya bagi balik, tinggal kamu buat pembetulan, boleh hantar final version sudah. Kalau saya rajin, kamu boleh hantar draft kedua juga untuk tengok kamu boleh dapat sebanyak markah yang mungkin. So far, boleh lagi? Boleh ikut? Ada soalan?
Tidak, Miss.
Tidak? Okay, right. And okay, your assessment criteria are as following. I will judge you based on your integrity and also your content. Content is berdasarkan di bawah ini lah. Ini berapa markah kamu dapat jawab, itulah content punya markah. Integrity saya nilai kamu dari segi kamu ada meniru ke tidak? Kamu ada sertakan, I don't think you need to write reference lah. Kamu ada sertakan cover page ke tidak? Yang saya suruh kamu buat pembetulan, kamu ada kasih betul ke tidak? Kalau kamu lambat, saya call 10 kali pun tidak jawab. Saya mau bagi markah atau tidak? So those kinds of things will be included in integrity. Content, senang sikit lah. Ini, I think there are like 44 marks for your content. Integrity macam 8 ke 10 markah begitu. Okay. And then this is the question. When you look at the document, you scroll down, that is the question. So case study one, as a science writer, you are asked to write an article on DNA replication for a website, but first you must do your research. Okay, using a table, you must list down the enzymes and proteins. Okay, ni kamu boleh jawab. Lepas kamu tengok video dan baca nota. And B, below are diagrams that show mechanism of DNA replication. Each number in the box is an event in DNA replication. And then the second page will be a table that you have to copy and then write down the number. Untuk case study 1, ini adalah berdasarkan 6.2 DNA replication. So, 1A, you need to write your own table. Tulis jadual sendiri untuk jawab soalan ini. Untuk 1B, for 1B, you need to look at this diagram. Diagram dari A, B, C, D, E. Kamu perlu baca jadual ini. Dan selepas itu, salin jadual ini. Tulis diagram. Tulis itu nombor 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 di sini. Ikut mana yang betul lah. And then I will mark you according to that. Any question about case study 1? I don't see any questions yet. Kalau tiada masalah, mau teruskan?
Okay, Miss.
Okay. Okay, nanti kalau ada soalan, tanya saja ya. Ini peluang untuk kamu tanya sebanyak mungkin untuk kamu punya assignment. Okay, alright. So, that is for case study one. Case study two. As a laboratory researcher, you have obtained three human gene sequences from the gene bank, of which they were found out to be templates that encoded for peptide hormone A, hormone B, and hormone C in human body. The production of these hormones can have pharmaceutical uses in the future, for example, hormone replacement therapy in treating disease. Expression of biological information is one of the important steps to produce exogenous proteins in biotechnology field. To figure this out, you look into the process of protein synthesis that occurs naturally in a cell. Mau saya translate? Ya, kamu paham sudah, saya tidak payah translate.
Translate lang, Miss.
Okay. Malu-malu kamu. It's like, bertahanlah, sikit lagi. Okay, so what is the premise of this story? Apakah situasi kita deh? Sebagai scientist dalam lab, kamu dapat tiga human gene sequence. Human gene sequence means DNA sequence daripada manusia. So you got this from the gene bank. You will get it like this lah. Kamu akan dapat macam ni, ada CCC, AAA, PTT. And then you found out that these three sequences are used to produce hormone A, hormone B, hormone C. Peptide hormone means that ini adalah hormon yang diperbuat daripada protein, peptide. Okay. So, yeah. So this is three types of hormones. The production of these hormones can have pharmaceutical uses in the future. Apa maksud ayat ini adalah? Penghasilan hormon-hormon ini kemungkinan ada kegunaan perubatan pada masa akan datang. Contoh kegunaan dia, hormone replacement therapy in treating disease. Hormone replacement therapy, kita gantikan hormon dalam pesakit. Contohnya kalau pesakit kita itu diabetik, okay, dia kandungan gula dalam darah dia sangat tinggi, badan dia tidak dapat regulate. Kita bagi hormone replacement therapy, kita bagi dia insulin, orang yang diabetik itu dapat menjalankan hidup seperti biasa. So that is an example of hormone replacement therapy. So whatever you have here is maybe useful for that. Ayat seterusnya, expression of biological information is one of the important steps to produce exogenous protein in biotechnology field. Expression of biological information adalah benda yang kita belajar chapter ini daripada DNA kepada mRNA kepada protein. Adalah salah satu langkah yang penting untuk menghasilkan exogenous protein. Protein yang dihasilkan di luar daripada badan. Protein yang dihasilkan dalam lab. Di luar daripada sel. Dalam bidang biotech, bioteknologi. To figure this out, you need to understand the process of protein synthesis that occurs naturally in a cell. So, using only one gene sequence from above and find out the processes involved in the production of the protein. Menggunakan salah satu daripada A, B, C, ini kamu pilihlah mana-mana satu kamu mau. Saya bagi kebebasan untuk pilih mana yang kamu suka. Berdasarkan mana-mana gene sequence ini, silalah explain macam mana daripada DNA ataupun gene, dia boleh jadi mRNA. Daripada mRNA, dia boleh jadi protein. So you must include the name of the process. Name of the process, contohnya transcription atau translation. Dan definisi dia. Kalau transcription, apa definisi dia? Dalam transcription ada apa step? Dalam transcription ada apa enzim dan RNA yang terlibat? Selepas transcription adalah translation. So you also give the name of the process which is translation, the definition of translation, the steps in translation, and the enzymes or RNA involved in translation. Dalam setiap step itu, memandangkan kamu menggunakan gene sequence, when you turn it into mRNA, ubahlah dia kepada 5 prime A, U, G, E, C, C, teruskan. Dan bila kamu ubah dia kepada protein, dia akan mula dengan methionine, lepas tu apa. This will make more sense after you learn 6.3, protein synthesis. And then, of course, write it in a paragraph. Your essay should not exceed 250 words. Okay. So far, any problem with case study number 2? Ada yang arahan saya yang kurang jelas?
Tidak, Miss.
Tidak? Okay, so ini 16 markah sahaja. Okay, and then we continue with case study 3. It has shorter instruction. You are interested to study the mutation in the regulatory gene LECI of a LEC oclon, which significantly alters the shape of repressor protein produced, causing loss of function. By using separate labeled diagrams, describe briefly the actions of the normal and mutated LEC oclon in the absence of lactose. You can choose to draw or use diagram from website or books or lecture note. Your essay should not exceed 250 words. So ini 250 perkataan atau ataupun kurang daripada itu. Basically, this is 6.4, based on 6.4 gene regulation. You have a LECI gene that can function normally, and then suddenly it is mutated. Dia ada mutasi dan dia macam rosak, causing loss of function. Jadi kamu perlu bandingkan macam mana kalau LECI yang normal dan macam mana LECI yang sudah mutated dan rosak. You can draw, you can use diagram from books, but make sure it doesn't look like your friend's work. Janganlah meniru walaupun kamu bincang dengan classmate kamu. Paling bagus kalau boleh lukislah diagram-diagram ni. Tapi kalau tidak mampu lukis, then kamu mau ambil dari internet pun boleh juga. Nanti saya akan bagi komen kalau diagram kamu sesuai ataupun tidak. Ini pun 16 markah. So sekali lagi, case study 1, everybody must do. Case study 2 and 3, you can choose which one you want to use. Mungkin sekarang kamu tidak berapa banyak soalan lepas kamu belajar sampai 6.3, 6.4 baru kamu ada soalan. So, you can always ask me in Telegram. Setakat ni okay, ada soalan berkenaan dengan dengan case study 3 ataupun in general?
Okay, tak, Miss.
So tidak? Far, tak, Miss.
Alright. Okay, nanti kalau kamu stuck mana-mana, kamu beritahu saja ya. So remember, you must have front cover and then answer can be typed or handwritten. You can submit your draft here in GC later. I will remind you that this assignment is 15% of your final marks. So kalau kamu boleh hantar on time, saya bagi kamu markah on time dan kamu boleh buat pembetulan, tidak mustahil untuk kamu dapat full mark. Okay. Oh, deadline. Did I say the deadline already? I think I told you the deadline already. Deadline is for draft 1st October, final submission 22nd October. Okay kah? Kalau semua okay, kata okay.
Okay, Miss.
Okay, Miss.
Alright. Alright, if there is no problem, one last thing I need to tell you is the takwim. Okay, kamu tahu ini adalah takwim kita. Okay, so for biology SB015 tahun ini, you already know that you are asked to come to college on the 11th dan masuk secara berperingkat. Berperingkat tu kalau tidak silap ikut kawasan tempat tinggal kamu lah. Labuan boleh masuk dulu. Sabah dengan Sarawak. Kalau tidak silap Sabah ikut kawasan, Sarawak ikut airport terdekat. So yang airport Miri akan datang on this date, airport Kuching akan datang on this date. Nanti HEP akan keluarkan memo rasmi, kita ikut memo rasmi daripada college. Sekarang kamu sedia packing dan sedia duit sudah dulu. Dan kamu sudah sedia dalam pengumuman Menteri Pendidikan hari itu, dia cakap sudah cuti pertengahan semester kita dianjak seminggu. So sekarang kita adalah week 9, hari ini 20 hari bulan, week 9. Kita habis, kita cuba masuk chapter 6 sebanyak yang mampu. Next week adalah chapter week 10. Kita habiskan chapter 6 dan kamu hantarlah kamu punya video draft. Kamu hantarlah kamu punya assignment draft. Dan selepas week 10, kita terus kepada week 11. Week 11 is 4 to 10th of October. Means garisan biru ini dibawa ke bawah. So next week, we will go into chapter 7 if possible. After that, one week holiday itu adalah masa untuk kamu datang sini, bukan balik rumah. Dan ambil masa itu untuk sesuaikan diri di college jugalah. And then after that, week 12, we will continue with this jadual. Saya betul-betul harap kamu dapat buat eksperimen 3 di rumah minggu ini, supaya kamu tidak payah angkut potato-potato alkohol-alkohol kamu datang ke college. Dan kalau boleh, kamu siapkan juga experiment 6 itu di rumah. Supaya kita tidak payah pikir banyak bila kamu datang sini. Tapi kita tengok keadaan juga lah. Most important is the experiment 3. Kalau kamu boleh siapkan di rumah, lagi bagus. Any questions about the takwim and the schedule?
Miss?
Yeah?
We do know that we go back, follow the jadwal or what? Will they give the jadwal to like go back one by one?
They will give the jadwal to go back by area, if I'm not mistaken.
By area, but for now haven't keluar lah.
Yeah, because they need to arrange with KKM in Labuan as well, and with MAS. Just wait in the Telegram. Nanti dalam Telegram they will post the official memo.
Okay, Miss.
Yeah, and any updates you can refer to your mentor as well. Kumpulan MEPRO tu. So for K05, you can refer to me. Di anak tiri kan? K04, you can refer to me. K05, K06, you can refer to your own mentor. Yeah. Kalau tidak silap, diorang sedang usahakan untuk dapatkan charter flight untuk yang Sarawak. Dan kita kena tengoklah Labuan cakap kamu mau quarantine 5 hari ke, 10 hari ke, 14 hari, tengok dulu. Jangan datang lagi, Felix. Nanti saya pujuk lah, saya bagi kuaci satu biji. Okay, any more questions? Yeah, quarantine di college. So you don't need to book hotel here, nanti quarantine di college. Kalau parents kamu mau datang, Saya rasa tidak juga dilarang, tapi fikir dululah kalau mampu dari segi kewangan. Bagi yang datang sendiri, jangan risau. Kalau tidak parents kamu pegang tangan sampai sini pun tidak apa. Daripada terminal, biarlah terminal ferry ataupun airport akan ada pensyarah dan staff daripada college yang akan jemput kamu, ada kenderaan untuk bawa kamu ke college. Tidak payahlah sampai bawa teddy bear kamu yang paling besar. Tidak payahlah bawa semua pinggan mangkuk daripada rumah dengan hanger-hanger. Ambil yang cukup-cukup lah, not too much. Think of how much you can carry with your own two hands. Kalau kamu tidak mampu angkat satu orang, then there are some things you can leave at home and you buy when you come here. Sebab last time yang hantar pelajar balik pun, saya nampak ada yang sampai 5 orang tolong dia angkat dia punya luggage-luggage. Sekali angkat luggage dia, bunyi piring, bunyi hanger. So, bring what you need. Bagi yang Labuan, kalau ada orang Labuan sini, sekali kamu lah mau bawa berapa kereta. Okay, any problem? Okay, alright. If I have the time, I will make a list of deadlines. Kalau sempat, nanti saya buat satu macam kalender untuk deadline, draft dan final dates lah. So, ingatlah kamu ada 3 benda yang kamu perlu siapkan, iaitu experimentary, lab report untuk experimentary, dan assignment, chapter 6. At least kamu tidak perlu hafal maklumat dalam chapter 6 untuk masuk PSPM. Okay, so if there are no problems, really, last question kalau tidak saya end class.
Miss, for the assignment, right? Mm-hmm. If how to say, we must do it. We can do research online, but we cannot copy all of the information, right?
Yes.
If somebody copy the information, then how? Like, it will deduct the marks, huh?
You mean if you just go to Wikipedia and then copy and paste?
Then the student.
Yes, I will deduct your mark.
Oh, we did that. Okay. So we just make our own sentences, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Use but the now, same point, but make your own sentence. Yes.
But now for assignment case 2 and case 3, right? We still don't understand what this means, actually.
It's okay. Then you finish learning 6.2, 6.3, 6.4. And later you go back to the assignment questions again.
Oh, okay. Then we will understand that what it means,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah. Okay. If you watch the video 10 times already, you read the nota 10 times already, you still cannot understand the question, don't worry, you can ask me. Tidaklah sampai 10 kali. Kalau baca, like, tengok video 1 kali pun, baca nota 1 kali pun tidak faham, then boleh sudah lah. I was joking about the 10.
Okay, thank you, Miss.
Okay. All right. Thank you very much, everybody, for your time and your attention. I will end the recording. That is